According to the Inspector General of Government, Betty Olive Namisango Kamya, the lifestyle audit, which was launched in 2021, is a priority to the Inspectorate of Government that is set to be rolled out early this year. However, the Inspectorate of Government is lamenting the lack of a legal framework in the implementation of a lifestyle audit created to fight corruption.
Conclusion, 2023 is going to be a year of increased activity, especially through lifestyle audits, as soon as we have the legal framework, which is almost ready, in which to operate the lifestyle audit. And we call upon all the people of Uganda to join the war against corruption in order to redeem Ugandans from poverty inflicted by corruption.
The opposition is concerned with the slow speed at which the Inspectorate of Government is moving with a lifestyle audit, vowing to move with a private member's bill to support enforcement of the famous audit. The Shadow Minister of Information and Anti-Corruption, Joyce Bagala, says the bill on lifestyle audit is among the set of amendments they are proposing to move this year.
We said that beginning next session, we are going to look at a number of laws that we think are necessary. If the government is not moving, we'll be compelled to move through private members' bills, and you can surely wait for that in the next session.
Okay. Unless the law is amended, prosecuting suspects under lifestyle audit is difficult, as their arrest and prosecution are untenable in courts of law. Bagala noted that the government has not demonstrated a political will to operationalize the lifestyle audit that came with a huge hype, mentioning several times when the strategy has been highly criticized by top government officials.
There is no political will by the NRM regime to fight corruption. I was telling you about the launch of the lifestyle audit, where the IGG was actually launching that lifestyle audit, where they could actually ask that you are a Joyce and you have been probably working in the media, how much money did you used to earn, and can you be able to have these many buildings with that money?
According to the figures by the IGG, 30 billion Ugandan shillings was recovered in 2022. Cases worth 500 billion shillings investigated and 50 public servants interdicted. 86 corruption cases have been investigated with 34 convictions. But the opposition says the recovery rate is very low compared to the money lost in corruption, which amounts to close to 10 trillion shillings annually.
That's what I asked for in that statement when I was responding, because it's not enough for you to come on the floor of parliament and tell us that you have recovered money. We need to understand recovered money from which MDAs. You have recovered money from which individuals? And these individuals, what has happened to them? Have they been prosecuted? Have they been interdicted? We need to understand. So the follow-up is very welcome.
Opposition legislators have challenged the Inspectorate of Government to set up the fight for the big fish if the public is to be convinced to join the IGG in the fight graft.
The IGG is to look for the big fish. This business of looking for mukene when there is a Nile patch in the lake is also unfair. There are people who have stolen billions of shillings. Let her go for those ones.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.